Yeah, well, that used to say, well, you can still see the glue marks. The intern houses were pretty much directly across the road. You could essentially walk in from that housing complex and get into work.
You know, we had this intern program that was kind of legendary.
It was just like this exclusive club of awesome people doing awesome stuff that maybe you could be a part of for just a little bit.
You get a whole bunch of young people, you bring them to some place, you teach them ROS, and then you say, go back to school and convert all your robots to ROS. And that's what kind of happened. For all the interns, Willow Garage was like a magical fairyland of robots. I mean, there was no ambiguity about that for interns.
I mean, the intern program was huge, literally and figuratively.
The intern program kind of became the lifeblood of building the community.
They're like, what? I get to like come and basically eat free food and live with robots? Yeah, I'm down.
In the summers, we often had more interns than full-timers, so we would joke that like if there was a mutiny, we'd be screwed.
You know, you'd see all these amazing videos that they came out with, and they'd be presenting this incredible work at conferences. And you'd be like, well, who are all of these people? Like, how can I be one of these people?
At the time, I thought it was just, this is a cool opportunity to go to the Bay Area, work with cool people, work on my thesis a little bit more, have a little bit of fun. That was my mental state of mind at the time. During the internship, though, it was vastly different.
Right now?
The internship challenge, I believe, took place in 2009.
So they had one weekend to hack together a drink delivery, and that's like no time to get anything done. That was also when ROS was super rough.
I mean, and the teams, all of them took it with different levels of comic effect because you got points for like if it talked to you or if it was witty or how it delivered the drinks and stuff like that.
And so we all got into the kitchen, we were setting up the robots, the interns were putting mustaches on the robots' faces to get ready for showtime.
And Scott walks in, he's like, and I brought a special guest.
Okay, I don't know who this is gonna be. And then Larry Page walks in the door.
yeah, that was a trip.
And sure enough, Larry was like surrounded by robots and a whole bunch of interns were like, okay. I really hope this robot does what it's supposed to do.
Hey, you. What are my choices?
Let's see, we've got Adwala, Naked, and Bottled Head Chechi Water.
Adwala.
Excellent choice.
And somehow, in one weekend, with very little sleep, they were able to pull off a whole bunch of demonstrations of robots delivering drinks to people. The intern program was amazing because of Melanie. She put in the blood, sweat, and tears to make that an incredible experience for them and to build them up as their own little community.
Making sure they were all looked after, not just from the point of view of like being junior interns who needed some looking after, but more importantly from well-supported from a technical point of view.
The intern program was my evil plan to spread ROS. yeah, it's pretty crazy. I mean, I think at the end we totaled it up and there was close to 200 interns that had gone through Willow Garage over the 5 years.
We brought in, frankly, some of the best and brightest students from around the world.
We also were pretty active in pursuing individuals that we thought were making an impact in the open source community, and we wanted them to come to Willow.
One of the reasons the students came to Willow instead of Google or Microsoft or somewhere else was because of the open source. They got to work on their stuff.
So that meant that when they were done for the summer or whatever period they spent there, they would go back to their lab and they would take everything they built back with them.
So this ROS organizational system and all these contributions by top graduate students became this core.
Basically, there was this magic energy between these users who at times outnumbered the engineers in the building. Just, you know, being able to go literally shoulder to shoulder with the person building the part of ROS that was breaking for them, and it just got fixed, and it just got fixed, and it just got better. And that magic, when I really reflected on it, was like, I think the core source of innovation at Willow Garage was that connection to the users that was just so organic.
And that allowed it to spread all over the world.
ROS had to be good to begin with and beneficial to people, otherwise it wouldn't have caught on. That being said, it was an opportunity for interns to experience both the software and how it's applied in the real world on the PR2. So I think that combination of not only participating in the development of ROS during the internship program, but also using it in real world situations was very convincing.
It was, they brought in new perspectives, they brought in new code, they took the ROS code and they brought it to their labs, and then next thing you know, everyone was using ROS on the robots, and it was largely because they came to Willow, and then they went back and they started ROSifying everything.